She reaches out her hands to the needy and extends her arms to the poor. She did not eat her food in idleness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Today we celebrate the memorial of Saint Monica, who you will remember had a son who was more than a bit wayward, a young man who lived as young men would have done at the time, a man without faith and a man apparently without morals as well. But Saint Monica gave her life to praying for her son, to praying for his conversion, to praying that he may find Jesus Christ and live his life according to the Gospels. And of course we know that her prayers were answered and her son became the great Saint Augustine, whom we would celebrate tomorrow, were tomorrow not a Sunday. All of us, I'm sure, in this life know people we wish would come to discover the gospel, would come to discover the love that Jesus Christ has for them, and would live their lives in a beautiful way that we know the gospel teaches us to. And so perhaps we can each pray for that person, those people during this Mass today, to pray that they may be converted, to pray that they may come to discover the love that Jesus Christ has for each one of us, the love that he has shown to us through his death upon the cross. This Mass today is a foundation Mass being offered for the repose of the souls of George, Alice and John Denson. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. O God, who consoled the sorrowful and who mercifully accepted the motherly tears of Saint Monica for the conversion of her son Augustine, grant us through the intercession of them both that we may bitterly regret our sins and find the grace of your pardon. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiasticus. Happy the husband of a really good wife. The number of his days will be doubled. A perfect wife is the joy of her husband. He will live out the years of his life in peace. A good wife is the best of portions, reserved for those who fear the Lord. Rich or poor, they will be glad of heart, cheerful of face, whatever the season. The grace of a wife will charm her husband. Her accomplishment will make him the stronger. A silent wife is a gift from the Lord. No price can be put on a well-trained character. A modest wife is a boon twice over. A chaste character cannot be weighed on scales. Like the sun rising over the mountains of the Lord is the beauty of a good wife in a well-kept house. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Keep my soul in peace before you, O Lord. O Lord, my heart is not proud, nor haughty my eyes. I have not gone after things too great, nor marvels beyond me.
My soul.
Truly, I have set my soul in silence and peace. A weaned child on its mother's breast, even so is my soul.
Before you, O Lord.
O Israel, hope in the Lord, both now and forever. Alleluia, alleluia. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Anyone who follows me will have the light of life. Alleluia.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you.
Jesus went to a town called Nain, accompanied by his disciples and a great number of people. When he was near to the gate of the town, it happened that a dead man was being carried out for burial, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. And a considerable number of the townspeople were with her. When the Lord saw her, he felt sorry for her. "Do not cry," he said. Then he went up and put his hand on the bier, and the bearer stood still. And he said, "Young man, I tell you to get up." And the dead man sat up and began to talk. And Jesus gave him to his mother. Everyone was filled with awe and praised God, saying, "A great prophet has appeared among us. God has visited his people." And his opinion of him spread throughout Judea and all over the countryside. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. We bring you these sacrificial gifts, O Lord, to commemorate Blessed Monica, humbly entreating that they may bestow on us both pardon and salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord. And all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
Make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francisco, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your love. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The kingdom of heaven is like a merchant who travels in search of fine pearls, and who, on finding one of great price, sold everything and bought it.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May the working of this divine sacrament enlighten and inflame us, Almighty God, on this feast day of Blessed Monica, that we may be ever fervent with holy desires and abound in good works, through Christ our Lord. We welcome in a particular way to this Mass today the two priests you see behind me, both visiting from Italy at the moment and spending the today in Cambridge. So fathers, we wish you very happy holidays and a happy time here in Cambridge and safe travels when you return home. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Docedo, et Spes nostra salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes oculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulcis, Virgo Maria.
May the divine assistance remain always with us. And may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Our Lady of Walsingham,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Monica,
pray for us.
All holy men and women,